How's it going? Let me tell you something. The world of Tarkov's been so violent for so long, but this new Scav karma system, that's all behind us. This place is, it's a place of cooperation, camaraderie now. I'm glad to see it. You know, it's a new beautiful page in the book of Tarkov. And only a madman would do anything to disturb the sacred bond of Scavdom. That's where I come in. You might have been thinking, damn, dude, I bet you Sam's loving the Scav karma system because now Scavs are working together. They're basically like the complete embodiment of what it means to be a rat. God, you're so fucking naive. Do you know how much it eats me alive knowing that one of these little Scav fucks might have like a, you know, a labs key card in his inventory or something? I can't know. I don't have access to it. I can't get it. Ever since this update, you see, what I've been doing is I've been learning from these scavs. I've been living with them, breaking bread with them, assimilating into their culture. All of this just so I could learn their weaknesses and exploit them. I found this emelya over here by this box. It's only a year out of date. Anyways, I know you're probably wondering, Sam, why are you making this video? What's going on here? I'm going to teach you guys how to trick scavs into thinking you're a scav as a PMC. This is a new level of assholery. First things first, dude. You gotta look the part, you know? Ugh, goddamn. I've seen this thing where people, name their loadout. You ever seen that shit? Where, like, Aqua has the tan man. Have you seen that? The tan man to Aqua is like a, it's like a shit brain placebo. And honestly, it's the most offensive loadout to a scav. The tan man embodies everything that a scav can't possess. Look at the colors a normal scav comes out in. They wear bright colors, and I think subconsciously, scavs have learned to assess, to judge other people based on their color. Scavs are starting to sound like fucking racists. The tan man's fucking aggressive. He's got this big backpack, big profile. You know, you catch one frame of this guy in your peripheral vision, your fight or flight's going out off the fucking charts. You want to pass into scav territory unmolested, you gotta blend in. You gotta wear the gang colors. And that's where my loadout comes in. It's called the Blue Boy. The Blue Boy is the antithesis to everything the tan man stands for. It's the least offensive loadout there is. There's fucking science behind this, dude. There's no science behind this. Science or not, you ask yourself, you know, like, what colors do scavs usually have on? And what colors do PMCs actively avoid wearing? Blues and reds. As a USEC, you can get this white raincoat. Looks fucking fly, dude. A pair of jeans. The cherry on top is the most distracting part, and that's the pompon. It's the chef's kiss of the outfit. The pompon is the single biggest indicator that you're not a PMC, because no fucking PMC would leave the hideout looking like that. Except for this guy. Why, Sam? Why would you do this? Things had just gotten better. Let me tell you something. It comes down to simple economics. On one hand, you have an airframe helmet, a slick armor vest, the beastiest gun you can wrap your dick beaters around, hundreds of thousands of rubles just to increase your survival rating by a little bit. And on the other hand, you have a pompon and a wiggle. And with those two things, you have something that nobody's ever had in Tarkov before. Relative safety. So have fun scavving, fellas.
Oh God, it hurts. Oh, it hurts. Oh, that's better. You've got the speed, you've got the power to crawl the wall. You've got the speed, you've got the power to crawl the wall.
Is that too geared? Am I too geared still?
Nah, you look like such a doofus. Nobody would come out looking like that.
Scav, I think.
I'm wiggling. Oh!
Did the wiggle work? Is he a friendly?
I mean, he took longer than normal, I feel like. Yeah, but he hesitated. The AI hesitated.
Yeah, the AI wasn't even sure. Hey, there's a guy right there. Guy.
Wiggling. He wiggled back! He did it!
Nice. He did it. We did it. Hey, look.
We did it. On. We're in scab hell, buddy.
I'm dead. There's a guy right next to me. How's he fucking that up? Got him. All right, I'm getting up. I'm going to come towards you.
All right. Wiggle. All right, come. We got one other. The dream's alive.
Yeah. Oh, wait. He's throwing down shit for us. What is it?
DVD player.
All right, now, say the words.
What are we saying to
him? Just hit F1.
Never mind, we still got work to do.
Nice, he's with us.
Nice move.
He hasn't caught on yet. He ran away. Oh, there's a guy looking down on us.
Is he a scab?
No. And I don't have a, Hey, wait.
Oh! Oh. What was I waiting for?
I was gonna give you your pompon. It was very important that at that moment, I give you your pompon.
Hey, wait!
You.
Oh,
is that
dude,
a
it's like, yep, it's like putting your hand in the lion's mouth. Oh, you did it right there.
That was rat nasty.
Put your hand in the lion's mouth, and then you started choking it somehow. Bryan looks cool as fuck.
Can't see you, can't hear you. Don't give a fuck.
What the shit? That's me.
What are you doing?
Oh my god, I am so sorry. You scared the shit out of me.
You just walked past us.
What?
Turned and aimed back at us. And bro, if you don't want to play, I said we could play Rise of Nations or whatever.
You jumped, thought you did a 360.
You aimed straight back at me, put a bullet hole right here next to my face.
And then I saw two guys, I'm like, oh my god, it's scams. Awkward.
Look at this. You have a flashlight?
You know what's funny is that our disguises worked, Bizzle. He thought we were scams. Now, when you go down here, Bryan, I want you to do a 360 and then get startled by the fact that you're facing the wrong way. Surely I couldn't have done a 180. I'm too quick for that.
And then shoot
Bizzle in the face again.
Yeah, I'd rather shoot at you guys dead than think I didn't make a 360. I'm sorry.
He landed, realized he didn't do a 180, looked at Bizzle, saw that Bizzle saw him only do a 180.
Right.
And then made a conscious effort to try to kill him.
You saw nothing.
But I was too dizzy from my sweet fucking 360 that I couldn't hit him.
He landed, and he whispers 540. Bizzle shakes his head and goes 180, and then he let it rip.
Oh my god.
What? Who killed me?
That guy.
Who's this? Oh, wiggling. On the wall on our left. I give him a wiggle.
Where?
I don't know. He's right in front of you.
Oh, wait. That's a PMC. It's a dipshit. I'm legging him. You gonna shoot him back? There you go.
Oh, you said you were legging him. I didn't know what the story was here.
Yeah.
We did the wiggle though. Dude, okay. You sent a lot of weird mixed signals now. I know he's a PMC.
He's a PMC. I'm not fucking wiggling at a PMC. What is this?
I feel a little weird about that one. I know he's a PMC, but we're abusing the wiggle.
Yeah, we were abusing the wiggle. But once I saw you as a PMC,
Is that what scavs do? That's what scavs would do, though. That's what scavs would do. Okay. Just trying to wrap my head around all this.
This guy's fucking new to method acting. He doesn't
The lines are already starting to blur, you know? Yeah. And it would be funny to take somebody to the exit thinking that we're scavs, only to find out we're all just a bunch of people.
That would be... You're like a double agent at that point.
You're all, baby.
A PMC tricking another PMC into thinking you should do the impossible by being a scav and exiting via scav lands, only to have him stand there with you, turn to him, hit F1, do a voice line.
It's the only way I can come anymore.
It's so convoluted. And as we're at the scav lands exit, I show him my balls. That's the final. And that's how I masturbate. They have to be so fucking confused by the end of it. It's the only way I can get erect now. Pure confusion.
Why?
I was about to say, more than anything, it's not how did you do it, it's why did you do it.
Yeah, why?
It's not the how that bothers me, Watson. The
logistics
it's the why.
Are clear. But these great efforts. Could it all just be for a boner?
Look at that insurance return.
Oh, yeah, dude. My insurance return was beautiful.
Nobody takes the pompons. I don't think I'm going to have to spend a goddamn dollar today. Hey, watch this. Let's see if we can drop something for him. Here you go. Here you go.
Oh, shit.
Did you kill him? Was it not him?
No, it's up in the tower.
Oh.
Did you kill him?
I killed him.
Yeah, he fucking got him.
He's right on the stairs. Yeah.
Got him.
Oh, you got him. Nice.
That's a shame, dude.
That was a player scav, too.
I feel bad. I feel horrible.
Okay, that guy's dead. There you go.
I'm going to give him a hemostat in case he needs some medical supplies.
I think he thinks we're one of him. It's a good thing I covered myself in scav urine.
He's looting the other scav. Alright, I won't shoot him.
Why not?
I don't know. Yeah, you said it was bad news to do that.
I mean, now I'm on the other shoulder.
Pick a song!
Come on, Sam. What's wrong?
Shoot him, dude.
What's wrong, you little bitch?
You're not a good enough shot.
I can shoot him if I wanted.
But you can't.
I can't, dude. You don't got what it takes, kid. Wow, what a bad shot.
Believe it or not, getting clips for this video was a lot fucking more difficult than I thought, because the trick isn't getting scavs to think you're a scav. That's not the hard part. Hard part's just surviving until scavs show up. We get hunted down by PMCs like every time. Now, this video is also supposed to be a lot more involved. There was originally like a weapon section where I was gonna show you guys like the best weapons to use where you can put good ammo in them but make them look cheap and everything, but my kid's going in for surgery and stuff, and I've just been doing family shit, so this is as good as it gets. the rest of this video is just insane scav footage more than anything, but I'm doing my best here. I'll see you guys in the next one. You know,
well, there's your raider gear.
Oh, wait. Two people are pushing? Three people are pushing.
Here?
Three scavs are... No, pushing that bunker.
Oh, shit.
They're agitated with the guy in there killing people.
You ain't no scav. You never be a scav.
I bet you this boy sleeps in a hideout. I can smell it on him. That's the Tarkov equivalent of being a trust fund kid, is having a hideout.
Your dad's a PMC, but you act like you're a scav at school.
Yeah. You're not one of us. You'll never be one of us. I bet you got a Bitcoin farm. I don't. I swear. Oh. I don't. I'm just a scav, guys. I'm a scav. I swear. I don't know, man. I feel like this guy's crafting a magnum buck back at home.
Shake him down. Hold him upside down. SSDs and hot rods falling out of his pockets.
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
Oh, he's in there to the left. He just healed up.
You sure you can't drop down?
Is that what... You're going to try to drop down into... I got to see it. Just fucking attempt it. I got to see it from this angle. That is the dumbest thing I've ever heard in my life. Do it. Do it. Yeah. How do you feel now? No, we're like third story. I'm gonna open my door.
Okay. Yep. Coming back up. I'm gonna open his door and go in and die, since that's where I'm at with this health bar. Ugh. Please have health item.
Oh, here. Oh, I don't have a health item. Yeah, please have health item.
Pockets have things. Squash, that's not gonna do it.
Sponsor. Rub squash on it. M67 grenade.
That's not gonna cut it. Why did you throw that out there?
It solves all wounds.
Oh my god, squash. Go into my pouch. Oh.
Ничего, с купчику все продам, завезем. С утра выпил, весь день свободен. Я толкнул все и в продуктовый. Опачки!
Pack it. Chuck it. Chuck it, hurry.
Close the door.
Oh!
Oh. Oh, where's Bryan? Or where's Bizzle?
I thought he was behind us. Oh, Bizzle's...
Who am I following? Am I following the wrong guy again?
Bizzle held the wrong hand again. We're in the food library.
We are in
Los Comestible Biblioteca.
I don't see how you do it. You'll be walking with us and anybody can hold out their hand and you're just like, all right.
Bizzle, you must have been
how many
really
times did you get raped when you were a kid? I gotta know. How many times did someone lead you off into the Alaskan wilderness?
Well, they couldn't rape me because they kept losing me.
Oh my god. I just clicked on that guy. That scared the shit out of me. That was the luckiest misfire because that was totally a scav. That could have been really bad. That was a lucker dog misfire. Holy crap. You like he was right around about to turn the crucible.
Okay, that only took about
what?
He had a 70 bullet.
Dude, what? did you just see where he shot? Oh! I'm so sorry.
What the fuck? What's
how many are there?
What the fuck? I was a kid.
Sketches.
Yeah, let me sign.
When I was a kid, my mom got the sketches with the lights.
Oh my god. Yeah.
He's a bad shot.
Anybody have a grenade?
Yeah, where do you want me to put it, though?
Yank it all the way down there, end of the road.
Point is...
Fly true!
When I was a kid...
Oh my god!
Okay, anyways, so when I was a kid, I had to light up Skechers, and I only ever got one
your
pair.
Your friend just died, you're talking about light up fucking Skechers.
I only had one pair.
Shot him.
Nice. I only had one pair because my mom stopped buying me them because
I really
want
to hear the story.
Up and down over and over again and in the elevator and she'd scream at me for fucking. Because I wanted to see them light up constantly and there's mirrors in the elevator.
I'm dead. We shut the fuck up, Bryan.
I mean, I don't think it was worth dying over that Skechers story. It wasn't really even that good.
I just think.
Point is, I would bounce around a lot with the Skechers and the guy in trouble. I got in trouble, so I never got them again. You know, like the lights die out eventually.
Wow, that was worth seeing Bizzle die over.
it was.
Yo, okay, save that one for the podcast. Jesus Christ, we're gonna need to hear that again.
That was liquid gold.
Audible gold, yeah.
Yeah, fuck.
You know how like people hate PETA because they don't actually care about animals; they act like they do.
Yeah.
Did you see that news story of in 2017? I'm just gonna turn down the game. I don't give a fuck.
Fuck that noise.
In 2017, PETA kidnapped a fucking chihuahua from a 9-year-old girl and euthanized it 5 hours later.
To what end?
They say PETA's official statement was like pet ownership is a form of involuntary servitude, like bondage. And not sexual bondage, mind you.
Yeah. I got you. I'm
trying.
Well, I mean, it could be potentially.
Yeah, it could be. This 9-year-old was a sick, twisted freak.
Just and PETA. Banging that chihuahua pimping it.
It had a ball gag on when they found
it. Had it in the streets. Yep.
And they euthanized this dog to set it free.
I mean, did the dog consent?
Dog was like, actually, I'm pretty cool with this 9-year-old. This me and this 9-year-old are actually pretty tight.
I meant to being euthanized because otherwise it would be murder, right?
No, no, no. They were setting it free. They know what's best for the dogs. The dogs don't know.
Well, I mean, I'm thinking now of what I know about dogs, and maybe they don't know because they don't even know that bacon strips aren't bacon.
They are pretty stupid.
And it only took me like 2 or 3 fucking bacon strips to figure out it's not bacon.
My leggy. There's no way that's Russian. That's not Russian. What is that?
Yeah.
What a stupid language. God. And what fucking was it? IGN was asking Nikita, he's like, man, how did you make these weird fucking maps look like such shitholes? He's just like, I just looked out the window.
And like, what did you base this weird dialect and strange customs on? He's like, this is just normal Russia. This is just Russia. The language is called Russian. It's like, wow, how did you come up with such a wackadoodle shitty language?
Yeah, this sounds like absolute garbage to my ears.
What makes it so convincing is just how shitty everything is and how much I hate everything in the game. It's like the most like anti-Russian journalist of all time.
Yeah.
It's really remarkable how you design the language to be as grating on the ears as possible.
Yeah, it's like if you gave a 3-year-old free control over your language.
Yeah. Stop! Stop! I'm betrayed!
So slow. If we want to stay in eyesight of each other, that's good too.
It was MNT. There's nothing there.
Go all the way to the end and take a left.
2 letters for that guy's body. M and T, bro. You know what I'm saying? I know.
Yeah.
Empty.
Brian's real fucking proud of that one, so I'm just gonna. I'll give him M and T.
I like how he said it again, like we missed it. Yeah. Like, oh, hold on, he didn't hear M T.
Yeah.
You guys heard what I did, right?
If we were at a restaurant with him, he'd be cracking us in the ribs right now with his elbow. You hear me?
Yeah, M T, bro.
You hear what I said? I said M T.
Hey, waiter.
Waiter, get in on this. Come here.
Yeah.
You want that fat 12% I'm leaving?
Yeah.
You fucking get over here and laugh at my empty joke.
Whoa, this place got cleaned up. This place is empty, you know what I'm saying?
I can't, no. It's so practical.
Oh, guy coming in here?
No! Oh my god.
What is the deal, so big
guy?
What? What?
He was talking Russian.
He was speaking Russian.
I thought he was bad.
He was speaking the people's tongue. The people's tongue itself.
I thought he was bad. I didn't get naughty points. I didn't get any naughty points.
Oh, maybe was he?
Okay, upon further review, I lost some scat points.
You take a left.
Oh, that's right. It's in that hallway.
You take a left. Should be right here. Yeah. You exiting?
Do I have any here? Take the slickers. Oh.
Fall on the floor. You would go like boop, disappear. It's still in the air.
That'd be so good. Yeah. Very cinematic.
He turned into a fucking candy bar.
He turned into a fucking candy bar. Bizzle, I'll get you out of here. I promise.
Yeah. The greatest trick the devil ever pulled was turning into a candy bar.
I'm a slickers.
Sam's lost. He's been lost for 45 minutes. He's like, I'm getting hungry, Bizzle. I'm sorry. Just give me a nibble.
I thought it was you. He's in there looting another body.
Where is he? Left or right when you go in there?
Right hand side.
I saw him shooting at him, but my fucking...
I might have just
got
him.
You got him.
I got him with the grenade?
Nice. Yeah, I rushed him and started shooting and he fucked
me. Alright, I'm gonna be kind of beefed up when you see me again. When you see me again...
He harmonized, I think, for a second.
For 1 second there.
I guess it's the delay or the lag, but you didn't even jump. You just like ran through.
Yeah, I'm not jumping.
Like a zigzag. How the fuck are you running through like that?
You just run and you zigzag and look up and your guy will just like materialize over it.
Oh, what the fuck?
And then you don't waste stamina like actually jumping.
That's so cheap. What the hell?
Why would you keep that gated? Yeah. Why did you tell us that?
Pro tip. Holy shit.
Okay, Linus tech tip. If you're at the white barriers, you just sprint and wiggle your head. And then,
yeah. Is it only for these barriers?
It's only for these specific barriers.
That works. What the fuck? It works.
Yeah, I just did it through.
It's so easy to do too. What
the fuck? Man, you think I got time to bring groceries in real quick?
Yeah, go do it.
All right, baby.
Somebody just opened up a knapsack.
They're all over us. That was not a good time to go get groceries.
Yeah, you think I have time to get groceries?
That was the worst time to go get groceries. Holy shit, I hope they got like. I hope Bizzle fucking sustains himself off like one bag of rice and a fucking a satchel of beans. Where?
Other side, they're coming.
Let's go. Coming?
I don't know. I'm closing all the doors.
Come on, I'm gonna preemptively move down here. Tell me when it's big enough to get through.
Okay.
Can you go through?
No, almost.
They're coming.
You're good.
Oh, we're fucking scavs!
Oh fuck, we're idiots! Oh my god!
Oh god! No.
The lines have blurred, finally.
Oh my god.
What is PMC and what is Scav?
Хуелоты, блядь, а ты хуелоты, конец тебе, блядь!
Я опачки. Я.
Ну что, неплохой день, да? Тетка все.